Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, we are gathered here today in search of something which has been quite rare in our fair land, justice. But it was not always so. Our land is an ancient one with the richest of histories. This land, this England, despite the columns and the inscriptions seen aplenty, was not founded by the Romans. Whilst the Roman Empire collapsed into the grasping tyranny of a failed state, our ancestors set off beyond the seas and settled this land. Whilst Roman Britain saw its currency debased, its population pillaged, and its people enslaved to slaves, our ancestors set out and brought freedom. The Angles, the Saxons, the Jutes. They did not come empty-handed. They brought not solely their arms, but their customs. And at the pinnacle of this rested their system of government, a law derived not from the pretensions of divinity, but from the nature of mankind itself. From common sense, for common man, a common law. A law above man, a law above kings themselves. Kings were not rulers chosen by gods. They were men chosen by their people. First in folk moots, then in Witans, kings were elected and they could be dethroned. Even Alfred the Great himself, the founder of England, was no exception. He was not granted the throne as first in line. He was elected as a man to defend his people. And that is the sole duty of kings, not to micromanage the lives of their people, not to tell them how to dress, how to speak, how to think, but to defend them, to defend the true trinity of our land, life, liberty, and property. Rulership in England does not derive from divine right. It does not flow from some god. It is a contract. It is a contract between a king and the people he serves. That contract is still the basis of government today. Everything in our nation is done in the name of the Queen, her government, her constabulary, and her courts. Her very sigil is hanging over our heads right now. Yet what has that truly become of today? Elizabeth Windsor's government rules not by law, but by unconstitutional diktat. Elizabeth Windsor's police are nothing but a gang of thugs that beat innocent people bloody for the basic exercise of their liberties. And the lockdown, whether it's tiered or otherwise, through the lockdown, as of tomorrow, Elizabeth Windsor's courts will be the only theatre left open in town, and one that only shows tragedies. And what greater illustration of that than today? A man put on trial for being in a group of three people, despite the fact that he was simply speaking whilst exercising alone. And in Speaker's Corner at that. People lose their jobs, lose their homes, lose their sanity, lose their lives. Elizabeth Windsor and her family cower in the luxury of Windsor Castle. The monarch is the ultimate check on government. No bill can become an act without her consent. Yet at every opportunity to do her job, Elizabeth Windsor has been complicit. She has put her cursed mark on every single unconstitutional act for more than half a century. When the government illegally abolished jury unanimity and began jailing people without a burden of beyond reasonable doubt, she was complicit. When the government illegally stripped non-Catholics of their inalienable right to bear arms to defend their life, liberty and property, she was complicit. When the government illegally stripped people of their right to legal counsel to defend themselves in court, she was complicit. When the government illegally began spying on every single person in their most personal and sensitive moments of their private lives, she was complicit. When the government detained people for years and years without any compensation whatsoever, even if found not guilty, she was complicit. When the government illegally rigged the electoral system to franchise foreign citizens to vote in our election, she was complicit. When the government illegally began sending armies of Stasi thugs to abolish peaceful protests, she was complicit. When they illegally locked millions of people in their homes, she was complicit. When they locked up journalists for journalism or citizens for speech, she was complicit. When they abolished free association, even in our own home, she was complicit. When they wouldn't even let us have one small corner in this entire land to speak our minds, she was complicit. There is only one law of England, and I hold it in my hand. Down with Windsor, long live the Magna Carta!
Hey! Oh, Seth!